Hi, this is Roger Petersen. In this video, I'm going to talk about the process of buying a car in Costa Rica. Now, this video is assuming that you're looking for a used car, of course. So where do you find a good quality used car? You can start around by searching certain websites that specialize in advertised used car for sale. I mean, right behind me, I'm flashing right now for you some of the sites that specialize in advertising used cars. You got Serre Autos, you got Encuentra 24, you got OLX, and you've got Craigslist of Costa Rica, among some of the websites out there that specialize in advertising used cars. Now, of course, you can also go to a car dealership to look for cars. Now, if the car that you found just happens to have been imported from the US, then you're able to run a Carfax on that vehicle to get more information about the history of that car. Now, this is only for cars that are imported from the US, because if the vehicle has been imported from Japan, from Korea, from Germany, then that's not going to be an option for you. All right, so let's get into the legalities of buying the car. So you found the car, you've already identified it, you want to make a deal with either the dealer or the owner of the car. So how do you legally transfer title to that car? First thing you got to do is you got to run a title search on that vehicle. I'm flashing right now on the back of the screen the information from the Registro Nacional, the National Registry. The vehicle section will keep information about all the history of ownership of that vehicle. And the first thing is to run that title search to determine if there are any liens or encumbrances that would affect the title to that vehicle. Okay, so let's go over a title report so you all can become experts in reading a title report for a Costa Rican vehicle. In this next section, we're going to break it down for you. Okay, so your first step at rnpdigital.com is, if you have an account, go ahead and log in here, and then that's going to give you access to the system. If not, register here for the first time and you can create an account. Okay, so now you're in the system. Go to the section here that says consultas gratuitas. This means these are free searches. Click on that. Now, once here, go to the movable property section, bienes muebles, right here. Then scroll down, go to the vehicle section right here, consulta de vehículo, and click on consulta vehículo. Okay, you've made it. Now that you're here, you enter the license plate number for the vehicle right here. And then once you enter that number, then enter the CAPTCHA right here and then click consult. And here is the resulting title report. So here you go, let's break it down. Characteristics of the vehicle. This gives you all the information about the vehicle right here. Characteristics about the engine. Gives you all the motor number, all the description about the motor for that vehicle. Owner information. Here it's going to give you all the details about the owner of that vehicle. It's going to tell you here, liens, no. Annotations, no. Infractions, no. Does it have any past infractions? No. This vehicle is clean. It's good to go. In addition to the title search that we talked about, there's two additional documents you need to check out when you're purchasing a car. The first one is to ensure that the vehicle has a current, what's called tarjeta de circulación o marchamo. Here it is. The tarjeta de circulación gives the vehicle the right to circulate on the roads. The other one is the vehicle inspection sticker called RITEVE. The RITEVE requires the vehicle to have been inspected at the vehicle inspection stations, and if it passes, then the vehicle is issued the certification. Whenever you're stopped by the police in Costa Rica, they're going to ask you for both of these documents as proof that the vehicle is up to date with all its legal requirements. So by now, all the stars are lining up for you. Your mechanic checked out the car. It's checking out great. Your notary or lawyer checked out the title, or you feel confident enough to check yourself. And now you feel confident. Yep, let's do it. Let's move forward. So what happens next is that you will have an appointment at the office of the Notary Public. The seller will show up. You will show up. You will tender payment. Simultaneously, you will sign a notary public deed called an escritura pública, and that is what transfers the vehicle from the seller over to the buyer. You will both sign, then the notary will extract that document and then record it in the vehicle section of the National Registry. And then it can take anywhere from 10 to 30 days for that vehicle to be registered and reflected the title transfer in the National Registry. Well, in Costa Rica, the only way that you can legally transfer title from a seller to a buyer is by using the services of a notary public. And in Costa Rica, every notary public is an attorney. So like it or not, folks, you're gonna have to get an attorney slash notary public involved in order to close your transaction. So what about the license plates? In Costa Rica, the license plates belong to the vehicle, not to the individual owners. So the license plates will always stay with the vehicle when it sells. How about insurance for the vehicle? Well, in Costa Rica, the mandatory insurance is that one that was paid in the tarjeta de circulación. Remember when I pointed this out? In this, when this was paid, there is a section there for the mandatory insurance. However, it's fairly low, so I always recommend everybody to at least purchase additional third-party liability insurance that would cover you against any damage that you cause to another person or another vehicle. So, I hope you found my video helpful, and remember, to truly enjoy Costa Rica, you have to be tranquilo. Enjoy.